author Amy Ziering, an Academy Award nominee and Emmy Award winner. One night only, Tuesday, October 11th at 7:30, the film will screen and the author will speak at the First Congregational Church, 2345 Channing Way in Berkeley. This KPFA benefit is wheelchair accessible. I'm Joanna Manqueros, a graduate of UC Berkeley. I work at Kaiser as a therapist, and I'll be hosting this uncompromising effort to deal with campus rape and violence. Tickets at brownpapertickets.com and our indie bookshops for October 11th, The Hunting Ground.
Good evening. You're listening to 94.1 KPFA Berkeley, 89.3 KPFB Berkeley, 88.1 KFCF Fresno, 97.5 K248BR Santa Cruz, and online at kpfa.org. The time is 9:01 p.m. Stay tuned for Suspense.
Tonight, we take pleasure in bringing you Suspense, a weekly anthology of notable melodramas from stage and screen, fiction and radio, presented each week to bring you to the edge of your chair, to keep you in suspense.
Guest, I presume?
Yes.
I am Dr. Arthas Vitagast, your new neighbor.
Interesting name.
Really? You think so?
No, not really. Just making conversation. Please, won't you come in?
Thank you. The music. Is that Martin Denny?
Can't be all Sturm und Drang all the time. So, you moved into the abandoned castle just down the north slope of Desolation Peak.
Yes. However did you know?
Have you been spying on me?
Because it's the only property within 40 miles.
Oh. Very well. You win this round, Dr. Artogast.
Come again?
As you well know, we are in the same business. Competitors, if you will.
Good for you. Business needs some fresh blood. And not just in the operating theater.
I don't follow.
It's a joke.
A joke?
Or not. Care for a drink?
A drink?
Yes. Helps me relax. You should try it. Wait, you are over 21, aren't you?
What?
Wouldn't want to serve alcohol to a minor, after all.
What?
The sheriff around here can be quite a prickly pear.
The sheriff? You're worried about the sheriff? You're the man who threatened the entire world with her climate control machine.
Ah, the weather or not.
You conquered the Belgian Congo with an army of robot bakeries.
Ah, I should have robotized the native species. It was so confusing for the natives. Most insensitive of me.
You tried to use your super magnetotron to disrupt the moon's orbit just for kicks.
What can I say? As you get older, you learn to pick your battles.
And so now you just sit around listening to Exotica and drinking Mai Tais.
It's a pink squirrel.
When I was a boy at Madame Villain's school for hopefully wayward boys, all the other kids wanted to be bank robbers, military dictators, divorce attorneys. But me, I wanted to be just like you. A mad scientist who ruled the world!
Oh, just for a few hours here and there.
I modeled myself after you in every way. My appearance, my mannerisms, even my speech.
Really? I hadn't noticed.
But now I find that you're just a pathetic has-been, content to wallow in the past glories and fruity mixed drink. Ah.
It's more of an almond flavor, really.
So the time has come for me to take your place as Earth's Mad Scientist Supreme!
Is that actually the title? I should have asked for a sash.
The student has surpassed the teacher. Therefore, be warned, Artogast. Step aside or be washed away in the tidal wave of impending godhead!
Leaving so soon?
You haven't heard the last of Victus Artogast!
I should hope not. That's me.
I mean...
Are you sure you don't want an umbrella? Ah, well... Dr. Vitogast, you're back.
Yes, Dr. Artogast, I'm back. Oh, yes, I'm back, all right.
And you brought a friend, I see.
A friend? A friend? No, this is no friend.
Oh, well, in any event, you're both welcome. Please, come in.
No, this is just a little something I created in the laboratory last night. A product of genetic engineering. A cross between human and feline DNA. My imp.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh, you see how nice. Imp, menace him!
Oh, this really takes me back to when I was a boy. I experimented with gene splicing, too. Gave it up, though. Too many variables. Robotics are much more predictable. But I still kept one of my early experiments around, crossing a bear and octopus gene. Say hello, bear-opus.
Bear and octopus genes, you say? So your feeble mind couldn't work out the coding sequence for a human-animal hybrid, then?
No, it's not that. But I did find that human-animal hybrids had a tendency to be somewhat less trustworthy.
Oh, they do, do they?
Oh, yes. And human-feline hybrids always prove to be the most troublesome of the lot.
Uh-oh.
Then maybe I'll have to eliminate the trouble.
But now the octopus? Perfect. It has nearly the same degree of intelligence as a human, only without the innate aggressiveness and instinct for treachery.
Yes, that's all well and good, but that's not why I came.
Did you pop by to borrow a cup of sugar?
No, I did not. But make no mistake, if I was in need of sugar, I would hold the world for ransom unless he delivered the entire sugar harvest of Cuba into my grasping hands!
Oh, well, if you're going to dream, dream big.
No, I stopped by to show you this!
Why would you look at that? It's a recreation of my old invisible beam!
And not just a recreation. I have improved upon your antiquated toy in every way.
Splendid! Why don't you give it a whirl?
Oh, indeed I will. Indeed I will.
Huh. so close.
The invisible beam projector. It's gone.
No, not gone. Just turned invisible.
That.
Radiation leak in the invisibility matrix. Not a dangerous dosage, but you don't want to be standing around too long before you fix it. I can give you a hand.
No! You've done quite enough already.
Oh, don't mention it.
Be rest assured that I will not forget this.
Well, I should hope not. After all, I don't want to be tripping over an invisible beam projector in the middle of the night.
No, not that. This insult.
Insult?
Good evening, Dr. Artegast.
But...
I said good evening, Dr. Artegast.
I forgot my invisible beam projector. It is I, Dr. Artus Vitogast.
Of course it is. You do understand that the primary reason for choosing a lair in a remote location is privacy, don't you?
Well, it certainly isn't because you're working on some nefarious plan for world domination. What are you reading there?
The Carpetbaggers.
The New York Times bestseller. Good God, man, have you no decency? If you're going to read, at least read Colts de Gaulle's or The King in Yellow. You know, something evil.
Clearly, you've never read Harold Robbins.
Enough of this foolishness. Imp! Bring her in.
Bring who in?
Let go of me, you creep!
Lainey Long, reporter for the Slag City Ledger?
And your loudest critic over the years.
Dr. Artegast? What's this all about?
Miss Long, I'm afraid that I am as much in the dark as you are.
I kidnapped her as part of my master plan.
That's all well and good, but it's your plan. Why bring her here?
Because I wanted you all to see it all unfold, since you've clearly forgotten how to do it yourself.
Junior, the only unfolding that's going to happen is when you have to unfold your fat lip from around my editor's fist.
Silence!
Imp, my radio phone.
Wow.
Edwards.
Mayor Edwards, this is Dr. Artus Vitogast.
Dr. Artegast, the world-famous mad scientist. Are you holding Slag City for ransom again? We'll pay any amount, just don't hurt us.
No, not Artegast, Dr. Artus Vitogast. Vitogast!
So you're not Dr. Artegast?
No!
Well, what do you want, Doctor, whoever you are?
What I want, Mr. Mayor, is $5 million, or else I'll unleash the protoplasma cannon on Slag City and make it match its name.
Sorry, we don't negotiate.
But you offered me anything I wanted when you thought I was Artegast.
That's different. He has a reputation. I don't even know who you are.
Dr. Artus Vitogast! Dr. Artus Vitogast! So you don't know who I am? Well, you will in just a moment. You'll sign Slag City's death warrant, Mr. Mayor. The last thing any of you see will be the flash of light from here atop Desolation Peak. Imp, my remote control.
You're going to fire your protoplasma cannon remotely? Radio-controlled, then.
Radio-controlled. Radio-controlled, ha! That's as obsolete as the ultra-laser gun you set up here in the observatory dome. No, my protoplasma cannon utilizes the latest in technology. It is satellite-controlled.
Satellite-controlled?
With this remote, I can rain devastation down on Slag City from anywhere on the globe.
But why would you want to? Half of the fun is getting to see the fruits of your labors firsthand, looking through the crosshairs and squeezing the trigger.
You'll find out in just 2 seconds. Why isn't it working?
What satellite do you have it linked to?
The newest satellite there is, Tailstar 1.
Which is only in range here for 20 minutes out of every 2.5-hour orbit.
But I just tested it.
Which means you have another 110 minutes before it'll work again.
But...
Chief McGillicuddy, send all available units to Desolation Peak.
But... Wait, I have a hostage, Lenny Long of the Slag City Ledger. Miss Long, say something to the mayor.
Don't worry about me, Mr. Mayor. Come get this crumb bum.
You heard the Lady McGillicuddy. Send them now.
But...
All right! Enough is enough! Did they teach you anything at Madame Villian School for hopefully wayward boys?
I...
Never! Give the hostage a free forum to speak, because they'll always say something selfless and heroic, especially Lenny Long.
Oh, what would you know about it?
I've been imperiling Miss Long since you were in swaddling clothes.
He has, you know.
Well, I'm not in swaddling clothes now!
Aren't you?
You shocked me with your baby ray!
Mr. Mayor.
Dr. Artegast, I didn't realize you were involved. I'll send the $5 million straight away.
No, no, no. I'm just an innocent bystander here. I believe Miss Long will vouch for me.
It's true, Mr. Mayor. In fact, he just stopped Dr. What's-His-Name from doing any further harm. Turned him into a toddler with his baby ray.
I demand that you change me back this instant!
If I change you back now, the Slag City police will lock you up and throw away the key. But they can't arrest a minor.
I demand that you change me back later.
All in good time. And speaking of changing, Imp, would you be so good as to take young Master Vitogast back to his castle? I believe he left a deposit, so to speak.
Stop looking at me like that! I'll be back, Artegast! This world's not big enough for the both of us!
Are you certain? You're taking up so little space in it now. Dr. Vitogast, you've grown up so since our last meeting.
Oh, you won't be laughing in a minute.
I'm not laughing now.
I was hoping not to have to do this, due to the incalculable destructive power that will be unleashed. But you leave me no choice.
How am I leaving you no choice?
Imp! The beakers! Don't use that tone with me! Give them to me! When I mix the contents of these two beakers, I will create the most powerful corrosive ever created, Oxychloride X!
Oh, you just made that up.
I did not! I heard it on an old episode of Lights Out.
Then you know what will happen if you mix those, right?
Silence!
Wait! Goggles, safety first.
Oh, of course.
You'll pay for that.
Threatening me, Dr. Autogast?
No, I mean you just ate a hole through my floor. I expect to be compensated.
Oxychloride X. It ate right through the beaker. Now it's loose upon the world!
And you consider that to be a good thing?
With Oxychloride X at my command, every government on the planet will have to pay me a king's ransom!
Except that it's not at your command. It's loose, and you have no means of stopping it.
Oh.
Vitogast, there's no sense in being master of the world if there's no world left to master.
But it's already loose.
Then we work together and find a means of neutralizing Oxychloride X.
Work together? I'd sooner see the Earth dissolved into nothingness.
When you were found as a baby on the doorstep of Madame Villain's school for hopefully wayward boys, wrapped in that very lab coat you're wearing now and holding a check for $10 million in your pudgy little hands, you were nudged down a career path. And you're so very close to reaching the culmination of it. Are you going to let petty jealousies take you off that path?
You're right. Wait. How did you know all that about me?
No time to explain now. We have a world to save. This one. Well, we did it. We neutralized Oxychloride X.
Yes. Sorry about your floor.
Ah, think nothing of it.
But by the time we neutralized it, the Oxychloride X had dissolved over a mile into the bedrock.
Ah, I'd been thinking of adding an escape tunnel anyway. So really, you did me a service. Saved at least a week's worth of boring.
So, how did you know all of that about me?
Ah, that's going to take a little bit of explaining. You know how you've wanted to be a mad scientist for as long as you can remember? How that very idea filled your every waking moment?
Yes.
And you know how you've idolized me for as long as you can remember? How the von Blauenops and the Murdochis of the world were nothing but rank amateurs by comparison.
Yes?
And you know how you chose the name Artis Vitogast as a small boy, even before you knew of my existence.
Yes?
Well, there's a very specific reason for that.
Yes?
Mad science runs in our family.
You mean you're my father?
Not exactly. You see.
What?
The other day when I used the baby ray on you, that wasn't the first time I've done that.
What are you saying?
25 years ago, I used it on you in a fit of youthful pique.
But I wasn't even alive 25 years ago.
The sort of peak a young, aspiring, mad scientist has towards his elder. And better.
Wait a second. Are you saying what I think you're saying?
Only I hadn't perfected the use of the baby ray then. It de-aged you too far, leaving you a squalling infant with no memory of who you are. I'm not your father, Vitogast. You're my father.
Well, that would explain some of my dreams. But not all. Some of them would only make sense if...
If what?
Where did you grow up?
Why, at Madame Villain's school for hopefully wayward boys. Oh.
You were left as an infant, I'll bet. And with a sizable amount of money as a nest egg.
So, 2 decades before I used the baby ray on you, you'd used it on me?
So it would seem.
I wonder how many times we've been through this. I wonder who is whose father. What do you say we just bury the hatchet, so to speak? Be a team, a family. Even if we don't know who is who in our father-son relationship.
Deal. But first, let me find a safe place for that baby ray.
Ah, that should do it.
By my calculations, it should impact the bottom in 127 seconds.
In the meantime, we can recalibrate your satellite controller to one that is in geosynchronous orbit with this location. And then...
So ends This World's Not Big Enough by John C. Alzadek and Dana Perry Hayes. Tonight's story of Suspense. Suspense is produced by Blue Hours Productions. Tonight's radio drama was written especially for Suspense by John C. Alzadek and Dana Perry Hayes and recorded at Melrose Music in Hollywood, California. Drake Bell was Artis Vitagast. Jonathan Goldstein was Vitas Artigast. Adrian Wilkinson was Lainey Long. Janet Vaughn was Imp. Sean Hackman was Mayor Edwards. And Steve Moulton was Barapus. I'm Daamen Krall. Next week at this time, tune in again for another study in Suspense.
Thank you for your generous pledges of support. Thanks for your generous donations, and especially for your individual declarations of appreciation. Those messages and your faith in KPFA supply us with the needed optimism and inspiration to continue in our struggle to maintain this vital independent media outlet. Your act of giving, your belief in our mission, is a powerful testament to the sacred bond between us. We at KPFA will fulfill our obligation by providing continued coverage of this dramatic election season. Join us Monday.